guarantee you it has.
Okay, so we're recording right now. We're doing the old star sequence. I'm in my garage right now. I got the camera set up. We got set up. We got our star punched out hole board, I guess, mat board for the background set up so we can sandwich those layers together and put them in sequence for our Ray Harryhausen experiment of rear projection. We're doing this all guerrilla style filmmaking. This is whatever I can scrounge up around the house. As you can see, I got it plugged in to the garage itself. I'm gonna make a kind of like a dark room right now as far as this background, so there's no light seeping out whatsoever. So basically you're not gonna see anything. This right here is Reynolds, I don't know what you call that kind of paper. It's like cookie sheet paper, and I'm using that as like a diffuser. So because there's so many holes actually punched into this board right here, that you could actually see the outline of the lights in the background. So I had to kind of diffuse that, and that paper actually did the trick. So now you can't see the borderline of the lamps in the back. All you see is a diffusion of light just kind of sprinkling out of that cardboard there. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the lights off real quick. I'm gonna show you like a little sample of what it looks like. You're not gonna see that background. I'm gonna throw a black mat, you know, kind of blanket over so there's no light seeping through whatsoever. But to give you a feel of what that will look like, I'm gonna diffuse it even more, maybe throw a strobe light in the back. But as we zoom in, you can see a little space, kind of like voyage sequence that we're going to be putting together. And as I sandwich these layers over and over and composite them together, you'll get an effect that you're flying through space. Also, too, if I change the speed, the shutter speed, and the ISO for a low light filter, you're gonna see the tracers. So if we zoom in pretty fast, it will, I don't know, I'm possibly thinking that it will give like a light speed effect. So we're gonna be working on that. Back to work in the garage doing this experiment. And that's pretty much it. We got the making here of our new sci-fi flick. And hold on just a second. Focus, Joe. And that's pretty much it, dude. We'll turn you back on in just a second once we're done with this effect. All right, as you can see that, okay, so as you can see, there's no light seeping through whatsoever. You see that we've covered, it's, you know what, it kind of reminds me of a big giant light bright. No light whatsoever seeping through. So we've created our own small indoor kind of dark room, if you want to call it, but that's exactly what I was going for. Of course we could fix this, but just a sample of what I had envisioned, and it's perfect. Kind of reminds you of the Twilight Zone just a little bit. This is it's good shit, man. All right, I'm ready to shoot, dude. And let's start. This is tracking. Okay. Cut. Alright, Joe, this is Optura Cam, point of view, dogfights, take one. We're going to do one in normal, and then with the space flight, speed of light filter on there.
cut.
All right, so that's a fucking wrap, dude. Up for the Space Odyssey tricks, you know? All right, so we are done recording. That is a wrap on the Space Odyssey sequence. It's been fun. We're done. We got our aerial tactics. We got our dogfights knocked out. And our light bright set was hopefully a success when it comes to videotaping space and movement on how you want it. That's a wrap. Cut.